friend because it helps me feel at peace. It lets me shut down from the rest of the world. I need to take a break from the decisions that I've had to make lately. Deciding if I want to get tested for Huntington's disease. It's been a decision that's been weighing on my mind for some time now. I remember I was overhearing my mom talk to a relative who wanted to come visit, and I don't think I was supposed to hear the conversation because she had mentioned something about my dad. And I knew something was up, and so I remember talking to her about it, trying to get it out of her, and my mom didn't want to tell me. She didn't want to worry me. But eventually she did, and I just remember going to the bookstore and looking up what Huntington's meant and reading the paragraph that, you know, I had a 50-50 chance if my dad ended up having this disease. I've been to a few conventions, and you know, I'd hear young people talk about, you know, as soon as I turn 18, I'm going to get tested, and I gotta know. But I always thought, you know, well, why do you have to know so bad? Why not try to put it to the side and live your life as best you can, and really only, you know, test if you absolutely need to. You can never go back. Once you get tested, you can't go back. December 3rd is my second appointment to meet with my doctor to go over the exam and get the blood test. I think about it every day. I think about being in the waiting room. I think about her opening the door, calling my name out, and going in there. And I'm so scared if I, you know, answer something wrong or if I do something that seems a little odd that she may think, oh, that's a sign, that's a symptom. This isn't fair, but what is fair? What is fair? You know, I'm grateful that, you know, even if I did test positive, I know that my life is worth something, and I know, you know, I know I've made a difference in people's lives, and for me, that's worth it. That's worth it. If I can tell people my story so that things may be a little easier for someone else, and that's really why we're here. Huntington's disease is a family disease. It's a neurological disease. Impacts the person many ways, cognitively, emotionally, psychologically. This disease has impacted my family unbelievably. You
you think, you know, this disease can start at any time. You know, if you accidentally trip, if you, you know, spill a glass of milk, whatever it may be, you know, if you check things 5 times, make sure the door's locked, you wonder, is this the beginning? You know, when I was 17 and we first found out about my dad, the doctor told me if I got pregnant, it'd be okay if I had an abortion. So that's something that's kind of weighing, you know, on me. The difficult choice is, you know, if I was positive and I got pregnant and we found out the fetus was positive, you know, then would you have an abortion? I don't know if I could live with myself with that. I want to have kids. You know, I think I would be a good mother, and I know my husband would be a great father. But we just gotta get creative, and we gotta, you know, we gotta pray, and we gotta figure out what's the best thing for us. I would love to have a baby someday. To tell me, it's funny with Huntington's disease because sometimes they get to the point where they say the same thing over and over again. When I'd come home from college, he used to tell me he loved me over and over and over and over again. Like he wanted to make sure that I knew. And I'm grateful because those are the times I remember fondly of him. I have made my second appointment for the test. I always wonder what you would say if you'd tell me to get tested or not. I didn't know you were so scared that it actually would happen to us. But I know that you'll be watching over me when I go in there. I just have faith that even if I'm positive, it's gonna be okay. We're gonna find a treatment. But I love you so much. You're always in my heart.
Kings and stars without a sky. Isn't the reasons why losing the calling that you've been faking? And I'm not kidding. It's damned if you don't, it's damned if you do. The lock you up in a sad, sad zoo. Oh, hidey, hidey, hiding what you're trying to prove. Hidey, hidey, hiding I'm not worth a thing. So your fortune's on the string. Take a very violent flight, and you will be changed in everything, and you will be in a very sad, sad zoo.
How
long?
Okay, so my best friend Melina.
Nice to meet you.
My mom, Barbara. And husband, Jeremy. Yeah. Hey, you too. Yeah.
So your results came back.
Yeah.
And you will not develop
Huntington. Oh my God! Oh my God!